friends, I welcome you all to today's video. Today we will talk about nucleus and nucleolus. In the last video, I had asked you a question. What is the difference between plant-like protists and organisms of kingdom plantae? The answer is, plant-like protists are unicellular, whereas organisms of kingdom plantae are multicellular. Plant-like protists do not have complex structures like roots, stem, leaves, whereas organisms of kingdom plantae have these complex structures. Let's begin with nucleus. The word nucleus is derived from a Latin word nucleus, which means core. That means something very important. Nucleus is a very important cell organelle found in cytoplasm of all eukaryotic cells, almost all eukaryotic cells. It is absent in prokaryotic cells like bacteria, BGA, mycoplasma. Nucleus is the first cell organelle which was discovered by Robert Brown in 1831. Nucleus is bound by a membrane which is called as nuclear membrane or nuclear envelope. It has two layers. The outer layer, which is drawn in black, is called outer nuclear membrane. The inner layer, which is drawn in blue, is called as inner nuclear membrane. There is a space in between these two layers. This space, this one, this one. This space is called as perinuclear space. Nuclear membrane or nuclear envelope provides protection, shape and size to nucleus. Nuclear membrane is housing, or there is a gel-like matrix present inside nuclear membrane. That matrix, this whole gel-like liquid, is called as nucleoplasm. Nucleoplasm is having two very important things, genetic material and nucleolus. Because of the presence of genetic material, nucleus controls the metabolic activities of the cell. This was better explained in my last video, DNA, chromosome, gene and chromatin. You can go through that. Nuclear membrane, the outer nuclear membrane, which is drawn in black, is continuous with the membrane of endoplasmic reticulum, this one. The perinuclear space is continuous with the lumen of endoplasmic reticulum, the space of endoplasmic reticulum. The nucleoplasm is in connection with cytoplasm. That means the things of nucleoplasm can easily enter inside cytoplasm, and from cytoplasm can easily go inside nucleoplasm by the help of some pores present at places. See this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. These are the pore-like structures called as nuclear pore, through which RNA or proteins can move inside cytoplasm, or from cytoplasm can move inside nucleoplasm. You can think nucleus as a very big football inside your room. Your room is the cell, and a big football is the nucleus. That football is surrounded by one more colored paper, for example, and there are certain holes, various holes at places. Actually, at these nuclear pores, there is a complex of proteins which is called as nuclear pore complex. These proteins have nuclear pore. These nuclear pore complexes are made up of nucleoporins. So nuclear pore is a part of nuclear pore complex which is present at various places. Now let's see the function of nucleolus. Nucleolus, the word plural of nucleolus is nucleoli. The plural of nucleus is nuclei. Do not confuse with these terms. Nucleolus is the center where ribosomes are actually made. Ribosomes are important cell organelles which help in protein synthesis. Ribosomes are made up of two parts, that is, ribosomal protein RNA and ribosomal proteins. RNA plus ribosomal proteins. These ribosomal RNA molecules are made at nucleus, and these are combined with ribosomal proteins, and as a result complete ribosomal molecules are made inside in nucleus. Nucleolus is not having any membrane. It is just made up of some filamentous and granular materials. You all must be aware of central dogma. In central dogma, DNA is copied to form more DNA molecules by the process of replication. So, DNA forms more DNA molecules by copying itself by the process of replication. DNA in the next step is converted into mRNA, that is messenger RNA. Messenger RNA can be converted into proteins. The process by which mRNA is made from DNA is called as transcription. The process by which proteins are made from mRNA is called as translation. And replication is the process by which more DNA molecules are made from existing DNA. So replication and transcription take place inside nucleus and translation takes place in cytoplasm. Below this nuclear membrane, there is a meshwork or a network of proteins that supports this nuclear membrane. Like this it is present. This meshwork of proteins is called as lamina. This lamina is made up of laminin protein. Now, a cell can have single nucleus or more than that. A few cells are also there which do not have nucleus. The cells which have more than one nucleus are called as multinucleated cells. The examples of which are cardiac cells, skeletal muscle cells, hepatic cells. Nucleolus can be single or more than that. There can be two or they can range up to six also. The multinucleated cells are of two types, synocytic and syncytium. Syncytium is a type of multinucleated cell which is formed by fusion of cell membrane of various cells. See, the cell membrane of these cells, they fuse to form a continuous membrane. As a result, they appear to be multinucleated. These are the nucleus of these cells. This type of multinucleated condition is seen in skeletal muscle cells, which appear multinucleated due to this process. So skeletal muscle cells are a type of syncytium multinucleated cells. There is also a type of multinucleate cell which is called as synocytic cells. Synocytic cells, there is no cytokinesis after karyokinesis. Normally when a cell divides, first the nucleus divides to form two nuclei. This nucleus will divide to form two nuclei. Then the cytoplasm and cell membrane, they will divide and they will form two cells. As a result, the process of division of nucleus is called as karyokinesis. The process of division of cell membrane and cytoplasm is called as cytokinesis. But in synocytic cells, only karyokinesis takes place but no cytokinesis. These types of multinucleated cells are found in algae. With this, we come to the end of this video. I'll ask you a question as usual. Why RBCs are called as enucleated cells? First, do they have nucleus? If no, then why they are called as enucleated cells? Why sieve cells found in plants are called as anucleated cells? I hope you like this video. Please hit the like button. Subscribe to my channel. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you.